Hi everybody, this is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat, and I have had a project laying on my crafty table for months, literally months, and I want to get the card in the mail to a special friend, and I can't mail it till I show you what I want to show you. So today's the day. I can't name a name to say this is who I got this from, because I saw it with several different crafters on YouTube, where they took fabric and they ran it through an embossing folder. This is fabric, ran through an embossing folder and used it for the background on the card. Don't you just love how this looks? Oh my goodness. It's a very super simple process. This is one of the cards I made. Now this will have to go as a gift topper or something, because it's way too high to go in the mail as just a plain card, unless I was putting it in with a gift. So I have some others to show you, and I'll show you those at the end. This is what I did on the inside. This is just a sticker. But let me show you. So I went and raided my niece's fabric stash, because her fabric stash is about like my crafty stash, and we all know what that's like. It's really bad. So I brought home some different kinds of fabrics from her. You're going to take a 5x7 card. It only needs a 5x7 piece, a little bit larger so you can trim it. And same thing with an A2, you know, a 4.5x5 size. Whatever size card you need, that's what you're going to need for your fabric. Now, what I did is I just took a glue stick and I took a plain piece of paper, anything you have. If you have some old scrapbooking paper that you just hate the designs on, turn it over, use the back piece and use it and get rid of it. And then there's two ways to do it. You can cut your fabric to fit your mat, or you can glue it on a piece and then justly simply trim away when you're done. I find this easier, because sometimes for me it's hard to line that sucker all up and get it down the way it should be, but it's perfectly fine whichever way you decide to do it. So we've got our fabric, we have a mat, which is going to be the size of a card. We have some fabric scraps, and I did spray these with some sizing because my niece was sure I needed to do that. I don't know if you need to do that or not. And then I have some other scraps here. This one is the one I'm going to be showing you today. And let's just kind of, I have this kind of here so I know what I want to do. So you take your fabric scrap that you've got. I have one more here, but maybe not. Okay, and you trim it all down. Let's just do that so I can show you really quickly. You're going to want to look through your stash, or if you don't have any and you want to do this, then you'll probably have to go buy one. But you're going to want an embossing folder that makes a pretty pronounced deep edge into your fabric. And, okay, that's close enough. Get that out of there so I can show you. All right, so I took water and I lightly misted on the front and the back of my cardstock that is now, or my fabric that's now glued to my cardstock. And then I found some embossing folders. Here's an Anna Griffith, Crafter's Companion, Cuddlebug. Really doesn't matter what you have, as long as you're going to get a deep impression. This one is Ornate Lace. And you can see this is called a 3D folder, and it's really got a deep impression. So my fabric's glued to my backing. I've misted the front and the back with water. I'm going to set it in, and I'm going to crank it through or run it through, whichever you have. If you have a crank or an electric embossing machine, doesn't matter. Anything works. Run it through, and when you bring it out, you're going to get a wonderfully embossed piece of fabric like this. Now I like to glue it to the backing, because you can see what the back looks like here. It gives it much more substance, and I went and stitched around. You don't need to do that at all. I just kind of wanted to see what the stitching would look like. Now this forms the base for your card, and here again, here's the base of the card with the embossed fabric. I love this. I just love the way it looks. It is so beautiful. So let's put a card together. This is the fabric that I used on this one. You know, like I said, you don't need much, just some scraps. If you're not a sewer, go find somebody that's a sewer. Or I believe it used to be, and I don't know because I haven't sewn anything for eons. You can go to places like Joann's that still sells fabric, and they have what's called remnants, and you can just pick up a remnant. So I'm going to, use some Sukwine tape on this, score tape, just for the easeability and how fast it will be to put this together. Now, like I said, my card is 5x7. You can use any size card you want for this. Just remember, you're going to want your embossing folder to be about the same size. So look through your stash and see what you have. I just cannot believe how beautifully, I just had never thought about an embossing folder embossing fabric before and how beautifully it turns out. Normally I would use glue on this, but for the sake of speediness to show you, we're going to use the tape. All right, so I'm going to want it this way. And I cut mine down. I had it the 5x7 and I cut it down because I wanted to add some other pretties to it. I have this piece of lace. And let me show you this. This is some lace that somebody gave me. It's quite stiff. Like it has a lot of sizing in it. And I want you to notice, let me see if I can get a piece of paper here. What do I have? Okay, I want you to notice this pretty little filigree flower right there, because I'll show you in a minute what I did with that flower. Now, I want to put this lace on the side right there like that. And I think, again, I'm going to use my tape because most of it will be not showing. And if you didn't know, you could use score tape on laces and ribbons. You surely can. It works just great. The biggest problem is getting it to come off because you don't have that totally flat surface right there. And I'm not worried about it being glued all the way across, you know, from side to side, because I have other stuff that's going to go down over the top of this. Now I have, I did that wrong. Let's take this up. And this up. We're just going to do that. That was the one thing I had forgotten. I had gone back and taken a piece of coffee stain paper. And I'm just going to lightly, because otherwise it's going to, and I'm not going to worry about the tape that's down there. We'll just use that as well. I'm going to put a little bit of glue. This is Fairly Art glue. See, I'm back and I'm no better than I was 2 months ago since the last time I did a video. It's just something wrong with me, I tell you. What can I say? But I'm not going to edit that out because, hey, if you're new to my channel, this is me. I cannot possibly do a video without a goober. It's just the way I'm made. So now that I've ripped up that score tape, let's put just a little bit more on right here. And see, my lace is still on there, so that's okay. And another one right here, and the other two are there. And I think for the purposes of making me feel better, I'm going to add some glue right in the middle of it too, so that I know that when somebody gets this, it's not going to fall apart in their hands and they're going to say, well, this is kind of a weird card. Okay, so now we've got our embossed piece and our piece of lace, and we're just going to, see, that's how I originally had it, was without the coffee dyed paper behind, and it just looked kind of naked. It needed that extra layer of something, and see, that looks much better, much, much better. And I'll go back and trim the edges here. Now, I want something down in this little corner. And I really like the addition of some music paper. And I have these old pieces of, I don't know where they came from, and a piece of doily. And I have this butterfly. Remember when I told you to take a look at this? Well, I was looking at it. I had the scrap left, and I thought, you know, if I fussy cut that out of there, I bet it could make a butterfly. And it did. The only thing I did was I pinched it right here together to make it form. And then the antenna simply is a piece of jute, the real thin stringy type. And I take a piece, some Barely Art glue or any kind of glue, put it over my antenna and twist it like this, and your antenna will get nice and stiff. I tried curling them, but that didn't quite work. Now, also, the only flat back crystals that I had were bright pink, and that didn't work. So I took an alcohol marker that in a beige and just colored them, and that seemed to work just great. So I have this little guy here that I want to go in. I have this Enjoy the Little Things. I have a sticker that I might put over it. So let's just start building our card. I think the first thing I'm going to put down is this piece of music paper, because, and I'm only going to glue it in the middle so I have room to tuck other things around it. And then I have this piece of, this is an avocado dyed paper doily. And the avocado dyeing was great. That was really came out with some fun things. I'm just going to kind of stick it back in here for some, whoops, for some movement. And then I have this Enjoy, and I definitely want the Enjoy to go right in here. And I kind of think I want to take my chopstick thing here and kind of give it a little bit of movement so it's just not so stiff to the card. You'll have to go through your fabric scraps, or like I said, if you have a friend that sews or somebody online that sews, tell them to send you a few scraps so you can play and run these through your embossing folders. I just could not believe the impressions I got. And of course, having the backing behind it really makes a difference too. Now, I think I'm going to stick another little, see, that's why I didn't glue it really tight. Another piece of this paper doily underneath right here, like that. And then I have my butterfly, definitely want him, but I think I want him perched on something. Let's perch him so he shows up a little bit more like that. And I think I'll ink around. So it's been forever since I've done a video. So how is everyone? Did you survive winter and the holidays and all this COVID mess within your families? I sure hope so. We've been very fortunate here with my own family. Everyone has stayed well and healthy and working, which is a wonderful thing. Not for me, because I didn't do that anymore. But I'm going to use, maybe if I can get it to come out, I'm getting down to the bottom of the bottom of my container here of 3-in-1. I have to go and get some more because I really like it. And that's what I glue the antenna on here too with that. And I'm going to glue that on here. I just thought that just really made it. And now we've got this. And let me get my big scissors out here again. I don't want those. I think I want my big ones. Okay. If you're new to my channel and this is the first time you've been here, I have, I think, 500 videos now. I've been doing this since, I think the first video I uploaded was 2009, forever. And as the years have gone by, I've picked up from all these wonderful crafty people online bits and pieces of things that they have done and how they did them. This year, my goal, oh, I had this. Let's see if this will work. I kind of wanted to just kind of, these are some stickers I bought. And my biggest complaint with these stickers is, man, it's hard to get the backing off. So I'm going to take this. But I just thought that this would be kind of pretty. And let's see if I, come on, get in there. Ooh, not there. Let's go this way. Like that. There we go. just to give it a little bit of shininess. You see there over the top of that, and another little added element. I've done a lot of soul searching for what I wanted to do this next year, and I have boxes of mini albums that I've made. I never got around to opening a store, so they're still sitting here, and I thought, I have so much stuff, products and things that I've gotten, that it would make me feel so good to go through and use stuff up. And I have, I'm going to just put this little strip, this is fabric and the lace, and I have the tape here, and I just zigzag the one to the top of the other, and it's going to go along the edge right here on the inside. Because if you're new to my channel, I like things on the inside of my cards. I just feel better to me. They're finished and they just look better. Okay, well, I guess that's there now because it stuck down. So that'll be okay. So I would kind of like to go through and use up things that I have around here. I need a lot of cards. I am just out of cards. And I was such a bad friend because I have a couple of close friends. I always give them a set of cards at Christmas, and I didn't have enough. So I couldn't do it. This is another one of those stickers, and I peeled the back off before I came on because I didn't want you to hear me cuss and scream because I couldn't get it off. And this sticker is, if you notice, I just put a little bit of score tape on that one side because that's not a sticker. But this, if I place it over the top like this, this is going to hold that down right there. And then what I have is I have this gorgeous dragonfly butterfly type thing, and I had some jelly plate paper laying here, and it was a heavy watercolor paper, and it was the offcut of something else, and it was orange and green and pink, and I thought, well, you know, really on the inside this would be perfect. So I went and found some butterflies and cut it out, and this is what I ended up with, and I just love it, and I wanted to kind of put that down here on the inside. So anyway, back to my story of the coming 2022. What I thought I want to do is I want to get my stash of cards made up, and I'll take you along on that journey because everyone seems to love the card making. I have a really good idea. We're going to go to Costco one day this week, and I want to go, you're going to really laugh now, because I want to dig through their assortment of boxes they have sitting there, because I am looking for a box that's 10 inches wide by 24 to 26 inches deep. Now, I found the perfect boxes on Amazon. They're a mail carrier box, and they have the hole in the front and the hole in the back, but they're 11 or 12 inches, and my space just won't accommodate that. So I'm hoping that there's some kind of a throwaway box Costco will have that I can cover and alter, because I have a great idea floating around in my mind for making making a holder for cards per month. So say I have my daughter's birthday is the end of the month. I have had her card forever, but I would have a spot for February and all my February birthdays. And as I make cards and I thought, oh, this is a great one for Angie, it's got to go here, I would put it in that February slot. And then behind it, I would just have blank or happy birthday or sympathy or whatever, the ones for whoever. So that's what I'm thinking. So here's my card. What do you think? It was so easy to make. It doesn't take any time. You're using up all of your scraps. Here's the inside. I love it. I've left it blank. I'm trying to leave more of my cards with some kind of sentiment, but still blank. Now, let me show you some others. This is, let's see, I don't know. This is the same fabric as this one. And I don't know what the deal was, but I cut around here. I can't remember whether that's the way the embossing folder, I did something or whatever. And I slid lace around one half and embossed this. And I'm holding it up here. Okay, see how the flowers are all embossed in there? And that's an embossing folder, and I don't know which one it is now. And then this is the inside. Just stickers that I had around, and I put my name on the back. That envelope I haven't done anything with. But that originated from this. Of them. Okay, and then this one, of course, I showed you. Well, I did. I don't know where. Here it is. Is this paper, this fabric. So that's that one. I'm sorry I don't have any more of this fabric. I just love it. This was a batik, and I loved it. Just loved it. This is one of my favorite cards, and I'm not sure who that's going to be for. Okay, here's some fabric, and that's this one. And look how this turned out. I'm not very good about using my flowers up either, but in this instance, the flowers just were beautiful. I backed this. The card is just almost a gray, but it's an off-white, and then I put the pink, and then I put this one, and now can you see the embossing here, and the embossing here? This was a different embossing folder. You can use just about any of them that you have. And then here's the inside with a sticker and just my name on the back. And I don't think I made an envelope. This is what got me going. My friend Whitney Costers, she just lives over in Oregon, just a hop, skip, and a jump. But with COVID and restrictions and staying close to home, we still haven't met in person. So this is the year, my friend. She sent me this beautiful piece of paper. Or paper fabric, and I thought, oh, I want to make this card. So look at this card. This is another embossing folder. Now see, this one only has the design up at the front. Let me see if I can find which one it is. Maybe I don't even have that one in here. I didn't pull it. But this one has the design up at the front, and you can see how beautifully that came through. I matted it again on the pinky color. This is, I think, an Anna Griffin sticker. It says, begin an adventure, and then I just have a sticker on the inside. But now on this one, I took the envelope, and I glued a piece of the fabric to it. And now this is the envelope that's going to go in the mail. So this is what's going to be seen. I love that idea. It is so stinking easy, but yet it just makes all the difference in the world of how the card looks. So here are the ones that I've done. I think I've done 5. And this one, oh, I thought I had covered that one too, but I hadn't. So there you are. What do you think? Oops. Move them down, Patty. Get them in frame here. I'm trying to keep you away from the edges of my desk because it's not a pretty sight, people. What do you think? I just think these are so stinking fun to make. And you can use up all kinds of scraps that are laying around. You're going to have a unique card because it's going to take the recipient a little while to say, because they're going to do that, exactly what I just did. They're going to go like this because they're going to see all that embossed stuff. So instantly, your fingers go to that to say, gee, that's raised. And then all of a sudden, they're going to be going, oh, wait a minute. Look at that. That's fabric. Yep, that's what's going to happen. So pull out some fabric or steal some from your friends or beg, borrow, or steal from somebody online, whatever. You only need small pieces. Make some cards and pop back and tell me how they turned out. Have a great crafty day, everybody. Until the next time, stay well. If you're not a subscriber, hit that subscribe button. And if you like the video, hit the like button because YouTube really likes that and they're kind of fussy right now. So all the help I can get is much appreciated. But most of all, have a fun crafty day in your own craft space. Enjoy until the next time. Bye.